Hello everyone. Today we are going to start one important topic in parasitology, that is Leishmania. Now there were some questions from Leishmania which were asked in the university exams and also it is important from MCQs. So let us begin into the same format which we have been studying the virology and the bacteriology. So the first is the classification. Now Leishmania comes under hemoflagellate, that is Mastigophora. Now this hemoflagellate, we have Leishmania and Trypanosoma. So in the next video we will study about Trypanosoma. Today let's crack Leishmania. Now Leishmania comes under hemoflagellate, Mastigophora. So let me take you to the classification. Now we will do this classification in some other video. So here is Leishmania and here is Trypanosoma in the blood flagellate, that is Mastigophora. We will do this classification in very simple tricks in some other video. Today let us focus on Leishmania. Now Leishmania can be further divided into old world Leishmania and new world Leishmania. Now the old world, now what you have to do, simply divide into visceral and cutaneous. In new world also visceral, cutaneous, along with cutaneous just add mucocutaneous. So it's old world visceral leishmaniasis, which is the typical Kala Azar we will study and is caused by Leishmania donovani. Then in the new world the visceral one is caused by Leishmania chagasi. Now these two are some odd words. Then coming to cutaneous, cutaneous means something cute, something very good. So it is like the tropical countries and the major, like something big. So these are exciting words, tropica and major. Similarly in the new world the cutaneous or mucocutaneous, it's caused by Leishmania mexicana and brazilensis. This is also very good word. So the visceral ones are the boring words, Leishmania donovani in old world and Leishmania chagasi in new world. Now here's old O everywhere O. So old world Leishmania donovani and new world Leishmania chagasi. But in cutaneous it is very fascinating words. In old world it is tropica and major, in new world it is mexicana brazilensis. And this cutaneous leishmaniasis is also known as Delhi or Baghdad boil or oriental sore. Now let me ask you a question. Yes, this chiclayer ulcer is caused by this leishmania, and your options are all of these. Among these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, among the 6 leishmania, you have to tell me which leishmania will cause this chiclayer ulcer. Write down in the comments and after this video I will tell you the answer. So let us move with the structure. So our first subtopic is always classification, the second is always structure. So this leishmania is an obligate intracellular organism whose life cycle runs between human and insect. And what is the insect? It is female sandfly, that is Lebotomus. Now let us see a bit of structure. So inside the humans, in the macrophage, it exists as a mastigote form. Now this first letter A for a mastigote and A for aadmi. So aadmi mein kaun sa form hoga? A mastigote form hoga. So obviously now if you know that in aadmi a mastigote form hoga, तो इन्फेक्ट कौन करेगा उसको? ए मैस्टिकोट तो नहीं करेगा क्योंकि वो तो ऑलरेडी आदमी में है. तो इन्फेक्ट करेगा प्रो मैस्टिकोट. सो द इन्फेक्टिव फॉर्म इज प्रो मैस्टिकोट. देन इन द ह्यूमन इट विल कन्वर्ट इन टू ए मैस्टिकोट. ओके, वी विल कम टू लाइफ साइकिल. लेट्स जस्ट नाउ फोकस ऑन द स्ट्रक्चर. सो दिस प्रो मैस्टिकोट. ओके, सो दिस प्रो मैस्टिकोट, नाउ आई टोल्ड यू दिस इज द इन्फेक्टिव फॉर्म. सो ऑब्वियसली इट नीड्स टू मूव. सो इट हैज अ फ्लैजेला. Now doesn't it look like a mirchi, patli wali jo mirchi hoti hai. So P for स्पेस पतली वाली मिर्ची. नाउ इट इज थ्री स्ट्रक्चर्स, दिस इज राइट, वी पी एंड एन. वी फॉर वैक्यूल, देन उसके नीचे पैराबेसल बॉडी एंड बिलो दैट न्यूक्लियस. नाउ न्यूक्लियस इज एट सम डिस्टेंस, उसने अपना मेंटेन किया हुआ सोशल डिस्टेंस. बट वी वी के ऊपर ए एंड वी के नीचे बी, दो स्ट्रक्चर्स हैं ए एंड बी. सो दिस ए नाउ दिस बी एंड पी, सो ये वाला जो पार्ट है ब्लेफेरोप्लास्ट प्लस पैराबेसल बॉडी, इसे बोलते हैं काइनेटोप्लास्ट. दिस इज योर काइनेटोप्लास्ट. इसे अगर हम वापस से ड्रॉ करें तो प्रोमास्टिकोट इज मिर्ची टाइप ऐसा, एंड देन यहाँ से फ्लैजेला निकला होगा, यहाँ से एक्जोनीम होगा, दिस इज एक्जोनीम, दिस इज योर वैक्यूल, यहाँ पे एक दिस इज ब्लेफेरोप्लास्ट, दिस इज योर पैराबेसल बॉडी, एंड ये दोनों को मिलकर काइनेटोप्लास्ट, एंड देन यहाँ पे न्यूक्लियस. अगर ए मैस्टिकोट में देखेंगे तो इट इज़ लाइक अ अंडा, ए फॉर ए मैस्टिकोट, ए फॉर अंडा जैसा ओवल है, यहाँ पे भी एग्जैक्टली सेम है, बस फ्लैजेला नहीं है. एंड इसी ए मैस्टिकोट को हम बोलते हैं एलडी बॉडीज, दिस मीन डोनोवन बॉडीज. ये जस्ट ऐसे था, आपको ज़रूरत नहीं है, बट स्टिल यू कैन रिमेंबर बिकॉज हम लाइफ साइकिल में भी देखेंगे. दिस ब्रूस ली, सो ली फॉर आवर लेस्मेनियासिस. सो ब्रूस ली को इन्फेक्ट करने के लिए एक प्रो आ रहा है, मीन्स वेरी जीनियस प्रो. सो प्रो मैस्टिकोट आ रहा है इन्फेक्ट करने के लिए. सो लेट अस मूव टू द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन. तो डेफिनेटिव होस्ट इज ऑलवेज ह्यूमन एंड वेक्टर इज द फीमेल सैंड फ्लाई. सो दिस इज द फीमेल सैंड फ्लाई जो हम यूज करेंगे, फीमेल सैंड फ्लाई. एंड इसके अंदर होगा प्रोमेस्टिकोट फॉर्म इसके प्रोबोस्किस में, जो कि इंजेक्ट करेगी ह्यूमन में. एंड कैसे, या तो बाइट के थ्रू, या फिर अगर हम उसे क्रश कर दिए स्किन पे, या फिर मदर टू फीटस ट्रांसफर भी पॉसिबल है, या फिर ब्लड ट्रांसफ्यूजन. नाउ द इनक्यूबेशन पीरियड इज 10 डेज टू 2 ईयर, अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 1 टू 4 मंथ. सो दिस इज अकॉर्डिंग टू PSM. अगर माइक्रोबायोलॉजी में देखेंगे तो इट इज 2 टू 8 मंथ्स, बट ओके 10 डेज टू 2 ईयर इट वेरीज. नाउ कम टू लाइफ साइकिल विच इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो ये है आपकी फीमेल सैंड फ्लाई, दैट इज लेबोटोमस. ठीक है, नाउ इसकी बॉडी में ए मैस्टिकोट इज कन्वर्टिंग टू प्रोमेस्टिकोट. तो यहाँ पे जो होगा वो प्रोमेस्टिकोट होगा, ये ट्रांसफर करेगी ब्रूस ली में, बिकॉज द ह्यूमन इज द ब्रूस ली, एंड एज द फीमेल सैंड फ्लाई इज अप्रोचिंग ही इज वेरी एक्साइटेड एज यू कैन सी. देन थ्रू द वुंड साइट ऑफ वुंड द प्रोमेस्टिकोट विल बी कंज्यूम्ड बाय द मैक्रोफाज. इनसाइड द मैक्रोफाज इट विल कन्वर्ट इंटू ए मैस्टिकोट फॉर्म. नाउ दिस ए मैस्टिकोट फॉर्म ड्यू टू सर्टेन मैकेनिजम्स डज नॉट डाई बट कीप्स ऑन डिवाइडिंग बाय बाइनरी फिशन, एंड अल्टीमेटली द मैक्रोफाज रप्चर. नाउ दिस साइकिल अगेन कंटिन्यूज, सम ऑफ द रप्चर्ड ए मैस्टिकोट अगेन इंटर द मैक्रोफाज एंड देन अगेन डिवाइड, वाइल सम ए मैस्टिकोट विल एंटर इंटू द ब्लड. नाउ वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड विच विल बी कॉल्ड द एलडी बॉडीज, दिस ए मैस्टिकोट फॉर्म और दिस ए मैस्टिकोट फॉर्म. सो ऑब्वियसली इट इज दिस ए मैस्टिकोट फॉर्म विच इज इनसाइड द मैक्रोफाज विच आर कॉल्ड द एलडी बॉडीज. नाउ व्हाट आर द मैकेनिज्म बिकॉज ऑफ विच दिस ए मैस्टिकोट डज नॉट डाई बट इज एबल टू सर्वाइव इनसाइड द मैक्रोफाज. सो इट सर्वाइव बाई थ्री मैकेनिज्म, बाई थ्री मॉलिक्यूल्स विच आर एलपीजी लाइपोफॉस्फोग्लाइकेन, जीपीआई ग्लाइकोसिल फॉस्फाटिडाइल इनोसिटॉल, एंड GP63 ग्लाइकोप्रोटीन 63. सो हाउ टू रिमेंबर दिस, आई रिमेंबर दिस सैंड फ्लाई, दिस फॉर द सैंड फ्लाई. इट हैज़ अ वेरी सेक्सी लॉन्ग लेग्स, सो सेक्सी लेग. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस सेक्सी लेग this macrophage is not even able to kill her. He don't want to kill her. So L for LPG, lipophosphoglycan, G for GP63 and second G for GPI. Fine. Then this amastigote in the blood will be again sucked by another female sandfly. And now this Bruce Lee is very angry. Now the period, the female sandfly sucked the amastigote. Now the period from the conversion of amastigote again to promastigote inside the female sandfly is known as extrinsic incubation period, which is 1 to 4 weeks. So this is our complete life cycle. I hope now you can easily remember it. So our third part, that is MOT, is over. And the fourth, this is not the fourth, this is in the MOT only. So pathogenesis. Now from blood, it will go into various reticular endothelial system like spleen, liver, bone marrow. Now what are the implications in each of these organs? The most severely affected is obviously spleen, and we already discussed these three major surface protein, L, E, G, G. So L, G and G. Fine. Now let us study one by one. So the first is spleen. Now this, keep in mind this representative diagram so that you can remember. So this is the spleen, and you can see the capsule is very thickened. The capsule is very thickened. Then the spleen is enlarged, splenomegaly. Then this spleen has become very soft and very friable, because of which on cut section there will be engorgement of vessels and it will appear very red. And you can also see LD bodies inside the spleen, and also the plasma cells will be high. In the liver, same mechanism. The macrophages of liver are Kupffer cells, so they will be high in number and they will contain the LD bodies. So the liver will also enlarge. There will be fatty degeneration, which will form nutmeg liver, and the sinusoids are also engorged and dilated. But the point to note is the hepatocytes are not affected, so the liver function as such will be intact. Then the bone marrow also, the macrophages will increase in number. As a result, the cell lineage will be very low, so there will be pancytopenia. So now this was the pathology, and from this all of your clinical features can be easily derived. So under the same column, the clinical features, our fifth part, splenomegaly, hepatomegaly due to bone marrow changes, there will be anemia, leukopenia, thrombocytopenia. Also there will be fever, lymphadenopathy, weight loss, then skin pigmentation. Obviously the name suggests kala azar. Hair will be brittle and thin. There can be cachexia, ascites, edema, renal involvement, secondary infection. There are so many number of changes that can occur due to this basic pathology. And that is the reason if it is untreated, within 2 years the patient can die. This Bruce Lee will die. Right. So okay. Now what about
lab diagnosis? Now you can either directly obtain the evidence or indirect. So there can be two classifications in the lab diagnosis. Either you can directly find out, or there can be indirect methods like the antigen detection or the molecular method or the skin testing or the serology. But the confirmatory are the LD bodies, because if you obtain the LD bodies, that means you are damn sure it is leishmania. So you can take biopsy from spleen, bone marrow, lymph node and also blood smear, then culture in novenicol macneal medium, skin in a liquid medium, and you can do animal inoculation. And in indirect, you can do serodiagnosis for the antigen antibody, then molecular diagnosis PCR, skin testing, leishmanian test, blood test, you will see pancytopenia, and non-specific tests like Napier aldehyde and Jopa antimony. But these are not used nowadays. Now I have divided this because this is an important question of your university exams, lab diagnosis. So you can easily do this flowchart and write. This has been taken from Panika textbook. In the treatment, you can use pentavalent antibody compound or liposomal amphotericin B, metformin, paromomycin or amphotericin B. Now let us discuss the small entity, which is
post-collagen dermal leishmaniasis. Now, this visceral leishmaniasis, after treatment, you have treated the patient, but in 3 to 10% of the patient, in 1 to 2 years, they will develop an entity PKDL. Now there are non-ulcerative skin lesion changes which can be seen. So the initially there are depigmented or hypopigmented macules, mostly on the face, trunk and extremities. Then there are erythematous plaques which are butterfly patterns on the face, and then there are nodular lesions. So it is DEN, depigmented erythematous nodules. And diagnosis is by, you take the biopsy from the nodules, what you will find? You will find the amastigot form, then you can do the culture or animal inoculation. Treatment is also liposomal amphotericin B and sodium stibogluconate. So this is all about leishmania. I think I have covered everything. And now the answer to this. So what was the question? It was the university question. It was classification. So this is the classification, the number one. Then LD bodies, we already discussed this part. Then life cycle, which we discussed, the sexy leg and the Bruce Lee and all that. Then pathogenesis, we discussed in this part. This is the complete pathogenesis. And the lab diagnosis of organism calling collagen, that is this complete flowchart which I told you this, right? So this chiclet ulcer is caused by leishmania mexicana, right? So that's it for today, and the next video will be on trypanosoma. So stay tuned and keep studying.